Good morning. Hello. Hello. Got a beautiful background. You can see the sun today. Yay. First day I think I've seen the sun since Seattle. But that's all right. Still had an amazing time. Today is our last day, full day on the ship. We basically have a sea day and then we visit Victoria, British Columbia, Canada tonight. Super excited about that. I'm hoping to get some tasty Canadian treats. Another Canada shirt, and I want to try beaver tails. So hopefully there's a store open that sells beaver tails because I really want to try one. But today I get to pick up my painting. We've got trivia. We've got, what else do we have? We have the morning show with Aaron. We have a Q&A with Aaron. Whatever else I choose to discover. And yeah, so last day, how sad. But beautiful behind me. You can see some mountains back there. But yeah, all right, we're on our way to adventure. Bye, y'all.
Diego, you have a joke to share with the folks today?
Yeah, it's not good though.
Okay. Perfect, we love that.
Why couldn't the toilet paper cross the road?
Why?
It got stuck in a crack.
I do. This is one of my favorites. All it's right. A knock knock joke. Okay. So knock knock.
Who's there?
Britney Spears.
Britney Spears who?
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Oops, I did it again. Right? Thank you. I got a woo. That's one of my favorite jokes. As a big Britney Spears fan, that one brings me a whole lot of joy. But
came in from playing a trivia, and I got the good by heart with some letters about debarkation mornings, and said is tomorrow. And I got some they put my other two tail animals with my good day by heart, with the good by heart. Jeez, I cannot talk this morning, but they took my bat. But that's okay. I still got these three. Of sorts. We did a grade school trivia. I did pretty well. I got a 16 out of 20, but the winner had 20 out of 20, and I didn't need a ship on a stick anyways. I've already got two, one for participating in the showdown and one for winning a trivia. Yesterday I won Outrageous Laws trivia, but today I played in a trivia game and I was one of the guest panelists, and for participating I got the 50 birthday Carnival medallion. Yay! I've been wanting one all cruise once I saw them, just because it is different than the ones I have, because it says 50th birthday. So I have 50th birthday swag now. All right, so up for the rest of today is we got Groove for St. Jude and some more trivias, and we go to Victoria. So I'm super pumped about going to Victoria. I've already explained why. And yeah, check y'all later and see the mountains behind me. Beautiful. It's beautiful to see ocean and mountains at the same exact time. So come to Alaska to see them both.
Rocks me to sleep. I don't know if any of you have, you know, kind of been able to lull yourselves from the ship. When I go on vacation, I struggle falling asleep, actually, because there's no movement. I have had some really interesting rocky sea days. One was on the Paradise. It was a very rocky day. If you stood on Lido and you looked at the funnel, you could just see it, like, going side to side. So the best place to be on a rocky day on a ship is at the middle. So the middle, both the middle of the ship and then the middle of it, like, lengthwise. That's where you feel it the least. And also a top tip is to eat peanut butter and jelly sandwiches on those days. And this is why, it's because they taste the same going down as they do coming back up. So that is, that's my top tip to you. But I was on the Carnival Paradise and the captain called me and he said, Aaron, can you make an announcement just advising everyone to, you know, walk very carefully when moving around the vessel? Everything is absolutely fine, but as you can see, it's a rocky day. So I said, absolutely. On that ship, my cabin was on deck 11 and my PA, I have a PA announcement in my cabin, so that's where I make some of those announcements from. And on that ship, I had a shelf above my desk and it had, you know, hairspray, perfumes, deodorants, toiletries, all that stuff up on the shelf. And I pressed the button to say, you know, use caution when moving throughout the ship. We hit a big wave and everything on the shelf fell on top of me as I was making that announcement. And I may or may not have, but definitely did scream into the microphone ship-wide. So that was not what you want to hear from your cruise director over the PA on a rocky day. So I went, into the mic for everyone to hear. And then my DJ at the time was out on Lido and he was like, what was that? You're not gonna do that again. So then I came back and readjusted it. So I'm not super seasick. I got really comfortable with it. The only thing it does is it makes me tired, makes me sleepy, if anything. And what was
Nelson from Texas? So I have a follow-up food question. How exactly do they figure out what percentage of people order what at the dining room, and so that they don't have too much of whatever dish? And do y'all ever get to eat, like, if there's leftovers from the dining room?
So, if there's leftovers, we can talk about some food. So we have the crew mess that I was talking about. So we have all kinds of different meal times. We've got, you know, breakfast super early, then there's lunch, then there's a tea time in the afternoon, then there's dinner, second dinner, and then everyone's favorite, which is called the midnight mess. All right, so the midnight mess opens at 11:30. And that's, you know, when you want your midnight snack, right? So we go down and that's where all the leftovers go. So all the leftovers show up in our midnight mess. So that's when, which we love, right? So there's fun sandwiches. We get the leftover bread from the dining rooms. And a question that people ask me all the time is, what do we do with all the leftover food that people don't eat, right? When your plates are taken away. So what we have on board is a biodigester. So all of the food goes into the biodigester. And then when we leave ports at a certain distance, we're able to discharge that food and then all the animals get to eat it. So there's fish and dolphins and whales eating guys' burgers out there in the world, which is just really fun to think about, right? And so I haven't seen any in Seattle, but there's some home ports like Port Canaveral and Galveston where you'll see dolphins when you sail back into port, because that's, they know ships are there and they know it's feeding time. So yeah, but we order lots of different foods. We are preparing over 10,000 meals a day in the galley. So your food services team works really hard. Everybody works really hard.
We would cry.
Again. Well, I've played a lot of trivia, ate dinner, got a fun little drink in the room, and we are in Canada. This is Victoria, British Columbia, and we are docked. Oh, no, we're still moving a little bit, but we're in Canada. We're getting ready to dock, and I can see the city up there. It's behind us. It's warm out here. I might be regretting this long sleeve business right now. But that's all right. The sun's getting ready.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know what time the sun goes down here. I don't know. And you can see back behind me. There we go. Yeah. So getting ready to get off the ship and I will go explore Canada. I'm hoping I can find beaver tails. Hoping. And some fun Canadian snacks that I can take home to try. Yes. All right. I'll check you all in Canada. Birdie, birdie. We are back in Seattle and they're kicking us off the ship. Not very nice of them, especially at 7:30 in the morning. But debarkation has started earlier than the thing said. And so, yeah, I'm gonna head up to wait for my number to be called and I'll take the shuttle back to the airport. Then I'll call the shuttle for the hotel. Drop my stuff off there and begin my exploration of Seattle. Goals today are the Space Needle and then whatever else I happen to be come across. So I'll check in later. Bye, y'all.